Green Revolution is in fact a discontinuity in productivity rise in the major crops, in wheat, maize and rice. 80% of all food is from these three crops. Now we've seen a discontinuity in productivity rise going up from 4 or 5 kilograms per hectare per year to levels of between 80 and 150 kilograms per hectare per year at sudden. That was in the 50s in the United Kingdom, the United States of America and in other parts of Europe. And in the 70s it was taking place in rice in Asia and Latin America. The Green Revolution as such has contributed considerably to an increased food availability. It has also created an enormous increase of food security at different places around the world. It has also at some places created some social problems, because we saw that there was also a change in farming systems which had also victims for people who could not keep up with the changes which were taking place. Now in sub-Saharan Africa there was no Green Revolution, and the Green Revolution which we are trying to create now in sub-Saharan Africa has learned lessons from the way we were doing it in Asia and in Latin America. We are much more oriented to creating also institutions and also systems which are fine-tuned to the specific needs, so that it is not just a technical and a technocratic exercise, but it is in combination of social changes in combination with technocratic changes.
Can you say something about the organization that you are involved in that is now working on this?
Yes, when we came to the diagnosis in the early years of this century on behalf of the United Nations, why was the situation in sub-Saharan Africa different from other places of the world? We came to the diagnosis there were 20 different reasons. And that is a lot of reasons in the agrotechnology, in the institutional, in capacity building, political will and an enabling environment. In all these areas we formulated recommendations and they were adopted by the United Nations and had to be implemented. What was needed was very clearly that we had to organize not only political will but also organizations which were taking the lead in implementing the changes which were urgently needed. That's why we created the Alliance of the Green Revolution of Africa. The Alliance of the Green Revolution of Africa is an Africa-owned, Africa-led and Africa-oriented and Africa-financed system.